In this video, we're going to look at another example involving a sampling distribution of the sample proportion, p hat. A researcher studying ADHD among teenagers obtains a simple random sample of 100 teenagers aged 13 through 17 and asks them whether or not they have ever been prescribed medication for ADHD. To say that the sampling distribution of p hat, the sample proportion of teenagers who respond no, is approximately normal, how many more teenagers aged 13 through 17 does the researcher need to sample if A, 90% of all teenagers aged 13 through 17 have never been prescribed medication for ADHD, or B, 95% of all teenagers aged 13 to 17 have never been prescribed medication for ADHD. Okay, so here's the deal. In this setup of this problem, we're told that the researcher chose a sample of 100 individuals. And in part A, we're asked, what if the proportion of teenagers who've never been prescribed medication for ADHD is 0.90. So in other words, part A is speculating. What if P equals 0.90? Well, if that's the case, then N times P times 1 minus P would equal 100 times 0.90 times 0.10, 0.10 being 1 minus 0.90. And if we do that calculation, 100 times 0.90 times 0.10 is 9. So that is not 10 or bigger, which means if p equals 0.90, I don't have a large enough sample to say that the p hat distribution would be normal. So our question is, what would the sample size need to be? How many more would we have to add to the 100 so that we would be able to say that the sampling distribution of p hat is normal? In other words, if I take n times 0.90 times 1 minus 0.90, what would n have to be in order for that to be 10 or bigger? Well, 0.90 times 0.10 is 0.09, so I would have 10 times 0.09 is greater than or equal to 10. So I would have n times 0.09 is greater than or equal to 10. And so if I divide both sides by 0.09, then n would have to be greater than 10 divided by 0.09 is 111.111 repeating. So that is 111.1 repeating, which means that I would need to have a sample size of 112 or more. So if we started with a sample of 100, we would need 12 more to be added to our sample size in order to have the ability to say that this sampling distribution of p hat would be normal. So our answer to part A, we would need 12 more teenagers added to our sample so that we know for sure that we have a normal distribution. Now part B, we're doing the exact same thing, except instead of p being 0.90, p is going to be 0.95. So again, if we start with a sample of 100, and if p equals 0.95, then n times p times 1 minus p would be 100 times 0.95 times 1 minus 0.95, which would be 0.05. And so if I take 100 times 0.95 times 0.05, that is 4.75. That is way below 10, right? So we would not be able to say that we have a normal distribution. So how many more above the 100 would need to be included in our sample so that we could say we have a normal distribution for the p hat distribution? So the same basic deal. So if I take n times 0.95 times 1 minus 0.95, that needs to be 10 or bigger. Well, 0.95 times 0.05 is 0.0475. So I have n times 0.0475. That needs to be 10 or bigger. So if we divide by 0.0475, then n's going to be greater than or equal to whatever that is. 10 divided by 0.0475 is 210.526. And so that would need to be 211 or more. So if we started with a sample size of 100, we would need 111 more teenagers included in our sample if the true proportion is 95%. So 12 more if the proportion who've never received medication for ADHD is 90%, 111 more if it's 95%.